Good day, everyone. For today's video, we will be talking about the safety health protocols. Hello, I'm Angel. We will be discussing why we should aim in providing valuable information on what to do and what to avoid during this pandemic.
Yes, that is right. We should aim to provide information which came from credible individuals such as those working as frontline staff, medical personnel, and reporters.
So let's have Rowan to explain what are the safety protocols that we need to follow.
Hello, I'm Rowan, and these are the safety protocols that we need to follow. First, follow distancing measures issued for your location and stay informed through information from trusted sources, such as WHO and your local health authority. Second, stay at home and avoid direct contact with anyone else if you feel unwell or even have a mild cough. This will help protect your colleagues at work and your family members at home. Third, if you're feeling well and need to go to school, you can reduce your risk of catching the virus by avoiding crowded public transport.
If possible, go by bike or walk. Otherwise, if possible, discuss with your teachers or supervisors if you can work at home. So, let's all grab for the part one.
Fourth, at work or at school, if you can, use the stairs instead of elevators and avoid using your hands to touch common objects like door handles, elevator buttons, or staircase railings. Fifth, if you work in an office, create distance-based meetings either through video conferencing or by maintaining at least a 1 meter space between people in the same room. And if you work contact with the public, stay at least 1 meter away from others as much as you can. Sixth, after commuting to and from work and throughout the day, clean your hands frequently and avoid touching your eyes, mouth, and nose. Seventh, ventilate your workplace regularly, keeping the windows open if possible, and make sure tables, door handles, and other frequently touched surfaces are disinfected regularly. 8th, avoid crowded places and unnecessary public activities. And find no contact ways to greet your colleagues and express affection to your friends and family. 9th, while maintaining physical distance, stay social. Contact your family and colleagues regularly to check how they are coping. Remember to seek ways to stay active and positive. Stay healthy, and let's all prevent the spread of COVID-19.
Summary, the main objective of this organization is to spread awareness and strengthen the communities through educating individuals about certain health protocols regarding COVID-19 and developing funds or charities for the community. The estimated budget for this project is 5,000 to 10,000 pesos, but any amount of funding or donation will do. With every 100 pesos you donate, you can potentially feed an entire family for a day, help spread awareness regarding the safety protocols for COVID-19, and contribute to the health budget of our frontliners. This is our opportunity to build back together, and only then can we protect the health, livelihoods, food security, and nutrition of all people, and ensure that our new normal is a better one. To know more about us, you can check the description box below for our contact information. Thank you.